The first step to create this part, we will select the right plane and make this sketch. Here, and this sketch will create the center line here, okay, between the radius. So the radius of this arc here is the same of this arc. It will be 150 plus 100 over 2, okay? It will be 125 millimeters. Make sure that this two arc is tangent each other, okay? And make sure that this point here is vertical with this one, vertical horizontal constraint, okay? So open the Fusion, go to create a sketch, select the right plane, go to create, select the arc, 3-point arc, click at this point, make an arc here, make another arc here, go to constraint, select the tangent, make these two arc tangent each other, and go to constraint, select the equal, make these two arc equals, the dimension, the radius is the same. And go to constraint again, select horizontal vertical, select this point and this point here, this point and this point here, and select this point and this point here. And go to sketch dimension, the radius here is 125. And just to check this dimension, the distance between this point here and this point here, or this point here and this point here, it is 250 millimeters, okay? Let's see here, 250 millimeters, okay, finish the sketch. Now we needed to use the pipe command to make this body here. And the diameter, the outside diameter is 50 millimeters. And the thickness will be 50 millimeters minus 45 millimeters. It will be 5 millimeters over 2. It will be 2.5 millimeters of thickness, okay? So go to create, select the pipe, the path, select this profile. You need to click here to activate the hollow here. The section size 50 millimeters. And the section thickness 2.5 millimeters, okay? So let's inspect this. The outside diameter 50 millimeters, and the inside diameter 45 millimeters. We create this. Okay. Now let's create the base here. To create the base, this base here. This base and this one is the same dimensions. So to create this, we'll create two circles here. The distance between the circles, 130 millimeters, and the diameter of these circles is 15 millimeters, okay? So go to create, select the top plane, select the circle, make a circle here with 15 millimeters. And another one here with 15 millimeters. The distance between each other is 130 millimeters. So the distance between the circle and the midpoint here is 130 over 2. Go to constraint, select horizontal vertical, select this and this one and this one. Okay, we made this. And here, go rotate this and go to create project, include project. Select these two profile, these two circles here. And press OK. Make this project here. We can hide this body. Let me rotate here. Okay. Now we'll make this sketch here. We have an arc here, another arc here, and an arc here, and we have lines between these arcs. These lines are tangent with the arcs, okay? And the arcs are, the radius is 15 millimeters in this true one, and here is 35 millimeters of radius. So go to create, select the arc, 3-point arc, make an arc here. Now select line, make a line and an arc. A line and an arc here. Okay. Go to constant, select the tangent, make all these lines here tangent with the arcs, okay? And here go to constant, select the concentric, select this arc and this circle. This arc and this circle here. And select this arc and this circle here. This arc and this circle. Now go to sketch dimension. The radius here is 35. 35 here. And the radius here, let me see here, 15 millimeters. And 15 millimeters here. Okay, we made this. Finish the sketch. We need to extrude this 10 millimeters, okay? The dimension here, 10 millimeters. So, go to extrude, show the bodies here. Let me rotate this a little bit. Select this profile and make sure to select this face here, okay? This profile. And extrude this to this side, minus 10 millimeters. But the operation here will be a new body. Press OK. We made this. Now, create a component from the body 1 and create a component from the body 2. And here in the body 2, select this one and go to move and copy. And here select the create a copy. So move this to 150 millimeters and move here to this side 250 millimeters, but here we'll rotate this. We don't need to rotate, sorry, but move this to minus 10 millimeters here, okay? And that's it. Press OK. We can check the dimension here. It must be concentric, okay? And the distance here, and the distance of this face here must be 10 millimeters. Okay. So now, so that's it. Here we finish our exercise. So thanks for watching, subscribe my channel for more, and see you in the next video. Bye bye.